new plan, rearranging my life and I won't look back ever again. Yeah, you ain't see me activated. You better hope that you never see me agitated. I think about my actions, plan them out, evaluated. That's how I end up on the top, man, I'm calculated. My mind's a weapon, my body is the engine. I'm never second guessing, I just do what I was destined. Cause I feel I got the blessing, persistence and obsession. That's how you keep progressing, I already learned that lesson, yeah. I'm changing who I am, I'm making a new plan. Rearranging my life and I won't look back ever again. You can't stop what's moving. You can't stop what's moving. I'm changing my life and I won't look back ever again. No fear, see clear, you deserve to be great. I know it feels like things get in your way. Push through those walls and the others will fall. Sit up, stand tall, you can get through. I need some energy, anxiety's no friend to me. I have a short memory, I don't really remember things. That's how I move on, that's how I stay strong. A new day's on, I'll keep moving right along. And I feel like the pain in the past, it needs to stay in the past. You gotta take off the cast. I wanna feel like I'm a new person. I wanna have clear vision and purpose. And I feel like the patient lasts. If you can move on, in your brain, I'm certain. I've done it before, and man, I'm not perfect. I'm changing who I am. I'm making a new plan. Rearranging my life, and I won't look back ever again. You can't stop what's moving. You can't stop what's moving. I'm changing my life, and I won't look back ever again.
Over actor.
Hey, everybody. Well, no one yet. Maybe one. I don't know. Oh, all right. Why is my chat not visible right now? Hey, Shisha. Okay, that's great. Chat's not working. Fresh. Okay, well, I guess no chat today. Oh. Yeah, no worries. I know it's morning for you there. Appreciate you swinging by though. Hey Kat, what's up, buddy? Yep, still awake. Oh. Hang on, I need to blow my nose. Bloody weather today's been shite. Hey, Steve.
You hide here, Velvet. I'm going back to help Celica.
I'm so scared. Arthur, please.
You'll be just fine with these. Celica enchanted them herself. They'll give you the courage you need to survive.
They will?
Sure they will. Now, have I ever lied to you? I'll come back for you once Celica is safe.
Yeah, they're pretty cool, aren't they?
It's scary, but don't give in to fear. Don't despair, no matter what.
I won't. I promise. After all, I'm Laffy's older sister, and you're a student.
Still warning on the package? Yeah, I doubt it too. Fantastic. Never tried him before.
On that day, the world began to change. Men and beasts possessed by evil spirits, hunting and killing anyone they could. But even in the depths of despair, only two things matter to me. The taste of blood-soaked flesh. And revenge upon one man.
Oh, I love coffee.
Luffy, time to wake up. Okay. Morning.
I told you to stop calling me Luffy. I'm not a little kid anymore.
Grumble, grumble, huh? You must be feeling good. Bit of a fever, I'm afraid. At least the new medicine's supposed to come today. Until then, you stay in bed, got it?
What? Aw, but I wanted to go to the Cape.
Sorry, you'll have to wait.
Can I at least read a book?
Don't trouble your sister, Lafayette.
I didn't mean to.
Arthur, done chopping firewood?
Yeah, enough to last through winter. But there's something else I need to take care of. Sorry, but medicine money will have to wait a bit.
I can earn it myself, then. Bring down a few prickle boars, and I'll have plenty to offer in trade.
On your own?
Arthur's first maxim. Plans must be solid and reactions flexible.
All right. I shouldn't doubt my student's abilities. Sorry to put you in a spot.
I'm sorry, Velvet.
Whoa, hey! What's everyone apologizing for? We're a family, right?
Right. I'll see you later.
I whipped up some porridge for you, okay? Be back by evening.
Thank you. Be careful, Velvet.
If I'm on the hunt for prickle boars, I'd better try the tranquil woods outside of town. This is for Luffy's medicine, so I can't mess this up.
That sucks, mate. no idea what's causing it, or...
Ever since the opening 7 years ago, this world's really gone crazy. Famine, freezing weather, and worst of all, this demon blight that's turning people into monsters.
I can't believe that people can really turn into those things. It's a nightmare.
Does no one know what causes demon blight? Or how to heal it?
No. What we do know is that when people turn into those monsters, I mean, demons, they gain incredible strength and attack humans on sight.
Huh. Whoever named it the opening named it right. It's like someone opened a portal directly to hell.
Come to think of it, Celica died during the opening, didn't she? It might be a good thing she died when she did. She didn't have to suffer through all of this.
It's good that my sister died? How can you say that?
Sorry. I didn't mean it that way.
You're a real idiot, you know that?
Sorry about him, Velvet.
Hey, Velvet. Is Lafayette feeling better?
No, not yet. He needs a little more rest, I think.
Aw, too bad. Tell him I'm looking forward to hunting beetles with him again when he's better.
Right, got it. Lafayette's illness sure is persistent. Yeah, that fever still keeps coming back, like clockwork. The medicine always helps a little bit, but still, that sounds terrible. Let me know if there's anything I can do to help. Thanks, but we'll be fine. At least we've got Arthur to take care of anything that needs muscle. And before he came, Celica raised me and Luffy all by herself. So now I have to do my best too.
You sound just like your sister. That optimism must run in the family.
I do? That's nice of you to say. I should probably stock up on a few things before I go into the forest. I don't have a lot of money to spare, but like Arthur always says, battles are won and lost with the preparations made before the first strike.
Oh, 30%.
The demon blight is a punishment sent to us by the Empyreans for forgetting the old prayers.
Who are the Empyreans?
The four Empyreans created the world. The one Empyrean shall bring it to peace. Be afraid. When contradiction permeates this world, the time of suppression will be upon us.
Are you okay? Want me to take you home?
No! Don't treat me like a child!
All right, then.
Oh, it's you, Velvet. If you're going to the Cape, take care.
Don't fall into the Shrine of Tranquility, right? I know. I'm not a kid.
Of course, of course. You're 13 now, aren't you?
I'm 16.
Thank you.
This area looks promising.
Did she even use that play thing? I thought it was all just kicks.
Yeah, that's how it's done. Come to think of it, Arthur hasn't requested his favorite dinner in a while. There's been so much going on, and the village always has him out hunting. That does it! I'll cook him up some prickle boar stew, just like Celica taught me. A healthy portion of nourishing meat cures fevers. Know your foes and strike where they're weak. Who's next? Is that all?
Well, I mean, she looks like she's got one attached to her wrist right now. When do I get my demon hand?
Be enough to cover the medicine. I'd better bring these to the store. This place isn't safe. That hole's gotten bigger. I've told them 1,000 times they ought to build a fence, but They keep saying it's forbidden land.
Spoiler alert, pal.
Even Sokka used to scare me with it. She was always, this is a gateway to the underworld. Well, I'm too old to keep falling for that nonsense.
All right, good. Thank you. Can I drop down? No. I've got to buy a folder.
I hunted. Are you there?
Third cousins, twice removed.
Maxim 3. Never waver once your sword is drawn. Control your feelings to control the tide of battle.
It's a thingamajigger. Right, so that was tearing thorn. Nicely done, Velvet.
Cirrus.
An exorcist art.
Pride and anxiety. Pity for the enemy. Thrill of victory. Your emotions run too hot. That will be your downfall. Agreed. It's one of her virtues as well.
Huh?
Yes, I know. But even so, she's got to...
Arthur?
Arthur's fourth maxim. Never let your guard down, even when victorious.
Got it.
In any case, this should be enough to buy Lafayette's medicine. I'll drop the prickle boars off at the shop before I head out.
Head out where?
The person I was supposed to meet is late. I don't think I'll be home tonight. I came out here to let you know. You'll have to pick up the medicine yourself.
Right.
One more thing. I saw a group of demons near the village. If you're attacked, run away. Am I clear?
No way! I can handle a bunch of-
Demons can only be challenged by those with the talent for exorcism. That's the cold logic of the world, and no emotions can change it.
Do you think I could become an exorcist?
Why is it you think that birds fly?
Why? Well, without flying, they couldn't find food.
It takes a particular innate talent to be an exorcist. Unfortunately, very few humans have it within themselves.
All right.
Tomorrow is Celica's Memorial Day. I'll be back as soon as I can.
Hurry back! I'll make you a quiche, just the way she taught me.
It could be fun, as long as they play Tubular Bells every time I walk into a room. It would definitely be worth being an exorcist then.
Groceries?
Yep. And you must have been out
hunting. Bacon.
Yeah, it was a good haul. Look at you, lady breadwinner.
Oh, if there's you were a bacon. Boy, what's that,
I think I'd be in love.
Good thing I'm a girl.
Oh, yeah? You ought to do
How
something
did
about
you
your
know
style.
You was
then.
Here, Kat?
Yeah. I kind of broke my comb. So get a new one.
Sure, I'd like to, but...
Hey, mister! How about a sale on combs for the pretty girl?
Huh? Oh, you two need something?
I'm fine, Nico. I'm just here to pick up medicine for Lafayette.
Oh, Velvet. I already told Arthur, but I'm afraid the medicine hasn't come in yet.
What? Why not? Is it because of the demons?
Seems like the demon blight's really taking a toll on the city. There's even a group of them lurking around here now.
When's it coming, then?
I can't say. And I don't know how much it will cost.
Oh, no.
Ugh. What is wrong with Midgand? I mean, don't they have an army or something?
Those guys? The demons already routed them a while back.
But... we're safe here, right? After all, your brother-in-law's an exorcist.
You're so sure about that? Arthur can't even use his right hand anymore. Poor fellow couldn't even protect his own wife and child.
Let me know when the medicine gets in.
Of course. For now, here, on the house.
You didn't forget, did you?
You promised to teach me how to make your special quiche. You mean for that apprentice animal doctor you had your eye on? You were serious?
Beyond serious?
Please. This is life or death for me. But I thought your folks weren't keen on the two of you dating.
Who cares what people think? The important thing is my feelings.
I like the way you talk. If I were a boy, I think I'd be in love.
Darn right!
Luffy must be starving by now. I'd better hurry home. Orthy and Russ seem pretty down today.
I know! They've been whimpering like this for an hour now.
Well, they've always been a bit wimpy. The other day, that kitty Rollo chased both of them up a tree by himself.
They're hopeless. Whenever it's thundering out, they both dive into my bed, shivering.
Orthy, Russ,
have a good day, Shisha.
You're Nico's bodyguards, right? Start acting like it. They're completely hopeless.
Maybe. But they're so...
Celica taught you how to make your special quiches.
Yeah, but mine aren't nearly as good.
Don't be modest! They're fantastic.
That's because there's a secret in the cheese and the...
You should try selling them in Taliesin. I'm sure they'd be...
We could make them together and take them on the road! We could even... Would it make more money than hunting fricklebores?
Definitely, maybe. Even more so if you could lighten up a bit in front of the customers.
Then it might be worth a try. I do want to buy Laffy a nice heavy winter coat. And Arthur's gloves are in tatters, so he needs new ones.
Oh, don't be so boring! I get where you're coming from, but come!
Think big? No thanks. I want a peaceful life with Laffy and Arthur. That's all.
You're impossible. Then again, maybe that's why your quiches take...
Oh. Wait, where am I going? This way.
Hi, Celica. I'm back. I can't believe it's been 7 years since we lost you. Oh, drat. I forgot to bring your prince. I know how much you, Mom, and I know your child would have too. I'm sorry. I'll pick some... I told you to stay in bed.
I was only up for a little.
Look, your fever hasn't gone down a bit. Go lie down and I'll cook dinner.
I'm sorry.
What's this?
A compass. It uses a magnet to tell you which way you're facing.
Woohoo! You can use the sun and stars for that.
And what'll you do if it's cloudy, huh? Thanks to this invention, we'll even... See? It's designed to stay level, so your heading will be true even when the ship is rolling with the wave. Pretty neat, right?
If you say so, Laffy.
Come on, it's a must-have for any adventure. Can't you see how useful it is?
You can tell me more about it later.
Did they hurt you?
Not a scratch, and I brought back plenty. I can hear Arthur already.
Gosh, Velvet, I think it's time you learned all my secret arts.
He isn't coming home tonight, is he?
How do you know that?
Sarah stopped by and told me.
Arthur's Moloch? Huh, you really can talk to Molochim, can't you?
Yeah, Arthur says I've got exorcist potential.
No kidding. I think you'll be an exorcist to rival even him. I can tell you've been learning all sorts of things from his book collection.
I really want to become an exorcist. I want to go traveling with you and see all the... I'll hunt and chop firewood and if demon... I wish I could do that.
You'll get there, Lafayette. It should only take... oh, 20 years tops.
It won't take me that long.
Oh yeah? You better prove it to me then. Start with this lovely meatball stew I cooked. Eat every last mouthful, even if you don't feel hungry. And take your medicine, no matter how nasty it tastes. No tricks. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, cooking time. First, I need to light the stove. Isn't this Arthur's book? Is Luffy really reading stuff this dense? Poor kid's gonna squint his eyes right out.
The day before Scarlet Night, Sis went prickle boar hunting on her own. She's almost as good a fighter as Arthur. So I know those prickle boars don't stand. But I worry that she's too athletic to... maybe she should try to be more late.
Little scamp. He just knew I'd be reading this, didn't he? It's so easy to light Arthur's firewood. I wonder what his trick is.
Velvet? Could you not put any spinach in the stew?
Huh. You'll never grow up if you're picky with your food, you know.
I know. But just for today?
Fine, fine. I'll leave out the spinach just this once. And I'll make it that curry flavor you like.
Really? Thanks, Velvet!
There's some of Arthur's special curry spice upstairs, isn't there? There you go. Not spice. Oh yeah, I saw Nico today. And she had very important... she's coming over in the next couple days, so be...
I will. I'm glad...
yeah, we've known each other since forever. Still, Nico falling in love? I can barely wrap my head around it. Luffy, you know, if there's a girl you like, you'll tell Big... you're a stubborn little brat, so you might need an older... oh, and she's gotta be a good cook. A pro in the kitchen...
knock it off, Velvet! You should be more worried about your own love life.
Me? I've got enough. For one thing, I've got to cook for you and Arthur since Celica is gone. Besides, getting crushes on strange men? I just don't see what's so... Luffy, what's wrong? Are you all right? I'll bring you some water.
I'm fine. You just said something funny is all, and it made me choke a bit.
As long as you're okay. Sorry, I went off on a tangent there.
Who knows what the future holds?
Yeah, but what more can I do? I've got a duty to look after my little brother, and I'm serious about it.
I know, but I'm trying to look after you, too. I want you to be happy, that's all. And it's not just me. Arthur worries about you, too.
Well, we're family, right?
Yeah, that's what families do.
Thanks, Luffy. For you, I'd kill every last prickle boar in the forest if it came down to it. What am I doing? I need to hurry and get dinner ready.
Time for chocolate. Chocolate sounds good.
Good boy. You didn't forget your medicine.
Well, I did promise. Tomorrow's a scarlet night.
Yeah, just like that night that changed our lives.
Velvet? May I sleep next to you tonight?
Of course. Okay, let's see. Today, I've got to dry some meat and use that cheese I've been saving to make a quiche for... Luffy? You little... Where have you gone? You better not have gone to the village alone! I bet your fever hasn't even gone down!
Sorry, I think I'm starting to doze off then. Oh, fuck, I hate my sleep pattern at the moment. Cadbury's selling the chocolate house you can build. It's got 6 large bars in the box to help with building the house. It was just the cheaper option to buy £13 worth of chocolate for £9. Nice. Well, maybe I can, I get paid Thursday. Right, just gonna see how much I got left after we pay off the overdraft. Wait, so what? I'll search for laughing.
Lafayette been here?
No. I haven't seen him.
Wait! That's one of Arthur's!
Actually, it's a copy that Lafayette made. A smart merchant would pay a pretty penny for this book. I gave him a fair trade.
Lafayette, did he really copy all that by hand? Oh, he must have done it to buy that compass.
No, though he gave it some puppy eyes. Told him I'd throw it in for free, but he said that it would be a bad deal for me. He's a good lad, but not the merchant type.
So, what did he use the money for?
I'm afraid my lips are sealed. You'll have to ask him.
Velvet! I saw Lafayette walking around. Is he okay?
He's not okay. Where'd you see him?
He was headed for the forest. I'll help you look for him.
Thanks. Do a sweep of the village, just in case. I'll check the forest. I know. He might have gone to the Cape to pick flowers.
I was going to have them join the search, but they won't move.
It's like they're scared of something.
Have you seen Lafayette?
Nope. Can't say...
All right. Let me know the second you see him.
Got it. Is he in bad shape?
Well, he refuses to stay in bed. He needs his rest, but he's always walking around...
I can't say I'm surprised. He's always... He likes reading difficult books. When I saw him the other day, he told me all about the latest navigation techniques and exotic farming methods, too. Only one kid in a million is as smart as he is.
You're exaggerating. Well, maybe not.
It's a shame. If he could go to school in the capital, I'm sure he'd make a name for himself as a scholar.
The capital? Isn't that days and days by ship from Taliesin? No way! Not happening. Even if he gets better, I could never let him go that far away all by himself.
He can handle it. He's actually a very responsible boy. I don't think you need to worry.
I couldn't handle it. I would...
Five bags of Maltesers, four bags of Minchels, and four crunchy bits. One multi pack of crisps, and it will be gone in 3 or 4 days. Well, now I'm getting jealous.
Hey, Velvet, did you hear the news? Tonight is going to.
I remember the moon turned red 7 years ago.
It's a red lunar eclipse. It happens every several years or so. Apparently, you can predict the next one according to legend. A crimson moon is a gate that connects our world to the next. It's also said to be proof.
You sure know a lot of.
Lafayette taught me just a few minutes ago.
You saw Luffy? Where'd he go?
Actually, I don't know. Sorry.
Oh shit, no, I completely forgot, dude. Can you chuck it in the live chat again and I'll watch it. I'll watch it before I end the stream. I'll watch it soon, probably. I'm quite tired.
Running off without telling me. What if something happened to you? You wouldn't be the only one hurt. Do you understand that?
I'm sorry.
If you want to do something, just ask. I know I'm a crummy big sister, and I can't afford to buy you all the things you want.
No, that's not why I went out. You see, it was just...
I get it. You're right. I forgot...
Yeah, so I was going out to...
You want to see the ocean, too.
Well, yeah, that...
Fine. Just...
Are you sure?
I am. But next time you run off like that?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. It's off to the Cape, then.
Hooray!
fuck did I quit? There we go. Alright. Subscribed. Fucking YouTube sometimes. I mean, you gotta admire his zeal, you know, thinking like, yeah, I can take it. It's only a little human. That's cool. That is cool. Alright. Thank you guys for hanging out. I'm sorry I'm fucking dozing off. Remember, there's the games up for the raffle at the moment. What I might do, because it doesn't really seem to be doing very well, is I might do the draw in a few days. Just to, you know, get games to the people that have bought entries, and then, I might see, you know, if I can find another way to, yeah, no worries, Bacon. Do, you know, I've got to try and do something else, because, yeah, at the moment I'm fucked, and I don't know what I'm gonna do when the site closes now. I'm getting, you know, closer and closer to that. So yeah, that's the plan. Anyway, I mean, unless, you know, unless it starts picking up or something. Oh my god, NCR, that's a lot of notifications. Alright, anyway, possibly Bacon. I don't know what's going to be going on this week. I want to start working on a video, before, probably before I go into the next Da Vinci Resolve course. I really want to, I want to edit something, I want to make something, and I need to start trying to I need to start fixing up this channel, otherwise I'm just, yeah, I'm not gonna be doing great. So yeah, all right I'll catch you guys later. Anyway, much love, ta-da.
Cruising in my lane fast, call it high speed. I've been working hard, yeah, I've been working nightly. If you think you'll win, ha, not fucking likely. I be taking shots, yeah, cold-blooded, icy. Watching numbers grow is what I call sightseeing. In the front row, run it up when they hype me. The following grows, they know how to ignite me. Call me CEO, I've been running shit right, see. And I ain't playing games, I create my own lane. Making pleasure out of pain, Turning losses into gains. I'm the boss, I'm making change. I've been rocking this exchange, Popping off and risking things. Gonna make a fucking name. I just wanna be famous. But I don't want that cheap fame. No, I'm not that vain. I just wanna be greatness. Going off every chance I get. I don't really take a loss, well, I'll admit. That's why I'll make it to the top, yeah, I commit. And no, I'm never getting lost, I get after it. Investing in my own stock, cause it's faster than any crypto hits go, let me spend. Everything that you see is something I invent. And it's only 1%. I'm gonna take shots if I miss all. Forget it, I'll take a fat loss just to learn all that's in it. I'm taking snapshots, learning how to fall and get it. I'm getting back up, always stand tall, don't sweat it. I never back up, I don't miss a thing or regret it. I'm always learning, you could call me academic. I'm always working, never been apathetic. Bad energy is like a poison, needs a antiseptic.